Dr. David Kimbro and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea. Intertidal habitats are in danger across our planet. They can be unfriendly places, and the animals that live there aren't what you call cuddly, but they are important. Salt marshes, oyster reefs, and seagrass beds are in decline. To help them, we have to better understand how they function. This is Florida's forgotten coast. It has large expanses of protected lands and towns where people make a living from what the Gulf provides them. It is an ideal setting for studying coastal ecosystems.
You're much more able to figure out how the system is naturally working in this type of environment as opposed to over locations on the Atlantic coast or even on the West Coast out in California.
From here, we are following two studies funded by the National Science Foundation.
The coastal ecosystems that we're studying are very productive.
They support our local economy and also really fueling our sense of enjoyment and wonder.
We're studying what makes seagrasses, salt marshes, and oyster reefs so productive.
So why we are out here really boils down to our needing to figure out the many different ways in which these habitats are important to us for economics or ecology, and also to try and figure out the many different ways that biodiversity and predators help keep these habitats healthy and therefore important to us.
In the next few months, we'll be exploring more about coastal habitats and In the Grass on the Reef.
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation.